establishment and the women who accused him.
Isn't it strange that after 40 years of constant investigation, people have waited to 4 weeks prior to the general election to bring their complaints? That's not a coincidence. It's an intentional act to stop campaign.
These accusations coming at a watershed moment as more and more individuals come forward to share their stories of sexual harassment or abuse implicating Harvey Weinstein, Louis C.K., and Kevin Spacey, among others. Now, the question for Republicans in Washington, Alabama, and all across America, how will they respond? Unless the election is delayed, Roy Moore will be on the ballot next month. Will Republicans choose to support a candidate accused of engaging in sexual misconduct with a minor? Will they denounce him and risk losing a key Senate seat? And if he wins, will they count him among their ranks? It's a defining choice. 42 Republican senators have responded to the allegations against Moore, most of them saying if the allegations are true, he should step aside. And the White House has echoed that same line as the president travels overseas this week. But Trump is promising further comments after he returns to the U.S. So will we see a more decisive response from the president? For more, let's bring in counselor to the president and one of his top advisors, Kellyanne Conway. Her voice among those advising Donald Trump as he decides whether to reject Roy Moore. And good morning, Kellyanne. The Washington Post story is now 3 days old. You've had time to digest it, time to look through it. Do you have any doubt about the veracity of those accusations?
I said very early in this process that the conduct as described should disqualify anyone from serving in public office, and I'll stand by that. The president and others in the Republican Party have made clear that if the allegations are true, this man should step aside. But I've gone farther than that, and I've reflected something the vice president said as well, which is everybody should know that conduct is disqualifying. And Mr. Moore has denied that conduct. I think you've got other people out there talking about what did or did not happen many years ago.
But that goes back to that if we prove this conduct, then he should leave. What is it that has to happen now for you to go into he should step aside?
Well, the one thing I will say is that the president also is not as focused on this as he is his major 13-day trip abroad. And so he made a statement. He's sticking by that statement. But he's not being briefed on this bit by bit because he is very focused on new trade agreements. He's very focused on global cooperation against a nuclearized North Korea. He's
but
very focused on combating terrorism.
And we'll get back to that. But let me ask you again, do you have any doubt about the veracity of the accusation?
Martha, I only know what I read, and I take very seriously allegations like this, particularly when they involve somebody who happens to be one of my daughter's ages. I take this seriously. I've tried to be a very loud voice for a very long time.
So you believe the
accusers? Sexual impropriety. I know what I read. I don't know the accusers, and I don't know Judge Moore. But I also want to make sure that we as a nation are not always prosecuting people through the press. He has denied the allegations. I've read the stories. I've heard not the testimony and the evidence, but what people are saying publicly. And I think that what we've all said stands. I came out I was probably the first person in the administration to come out because I happened to be interviewed on a different network about a different topic, tax cuts. And I said, this conduct should be disqualifying. I mean, I look around and I say, is this the best
we can do? But we're still, Roy Moore says that, too, that conduct like that should be disqualifying. He's just saying he didn't do it. So what's the standard of proof here? It's one thing to say this is terrible conduct. It is terrible conduct. I'm not sure anyone would disagree with you. But the question is, and you are an advisor to the president, you have been following this. What is your standard of proof here? I mean, you either believe the women or you don't. And this isn't a trial.
Well, you said it best. It's not a trial. What do you mean the standard of proof and the evidence?
What does it take for you to say he should resign? What has to happen before you would advise the president to say Roy Moore should step aside?
The president said he should step aside if the allegations are true.
So where does the lie?
But Martha, hold on. I want to broaden this conversation. It would be a very dangerous precedent for any of us, for any person in this country, to just be cast aside as guilty because of press reports. This is a democracy with a constitutional system that allows us to have a process. So if we're not in trial here, I only know what I read, and what I read is very disturbing, and what I read offends me greatly as a woman, as a mother of three young girls.
Understood, but what you're saying essentially is maybe those four women are lying.
No, I didn't say that.
We had four women who the Post came to.
I didn't say that. Okay, I didn't say that. But I also know that credibility has not been imbued on other people when they've tried to raise issues like this based on their political affiliations and based on who they work for. And we know that. There were many accusers over the years. There was much evidence against a former president and very little coverage of that, respectfully. The fact is that on this particular issue, we need to have a serious conversation. But on this one, you're talking about decades-long conduct, allegations in the press. And we already, in this conversation, have probably spent more time talking about Roy Moore and this than we've talked about a Democratic United States senator who's sitting in a federal courthouse as a criminal defendant in a trial, has been indicted on some serious criminal counts, and we can't get any coverage on
it. And we will be talking about that. We will be talking about that.
I want to be very explicit here. I denounce that conduct. And if the allegations are true,